Hello guys! Today is August 15th, which means it is India's Independence Day. And I thought in honor of that, it would be really fun for me to give you five recommendations of books that I really love by Indian authors. Four out of the five of these books also feature Indian protagonists. Okay, so let's start out with my first pick. My first recommendation is The Girl in the Garden by Kamala Nair. This is an adult, kind of like family drama novel. This book starts out with our main character who is an adult and she's writing a letter to her partner. She's like, sorry, I suddenly need to go to India. There's a lot of stuff you don't know about me. I need to be in India right now. I'll talk to you later. And she just kind of leaves the country without much explanation. But she like leaves him this really detailed account of when she was, I think, 10 or 11 years old. She was a little girl growing up in Minnesota, and she spends one summer with her mother back in her mother's native India. And while she's there, she gets to be with her large Indian family, and she kind of uncovers a lot of secrets about her mother's past. It's an adult story told through a child's perspective. I really, really loved this book. I thought that it was beautifully written and it was so lush and atmospheric. I loved the setting and I thought that the writing did a really good job of bringing it to life. The general like feeling of this book had such magical quality to it where I kind of felt like I was in a fairy tale, or there was some sort of like magical realism that might be creeping into the story. Just something about it felt just really like subtly fantastical. I loved reading a book set in India. I loved seeing the world from this young girl's perspective, and I thought that the mystery surrounding her family was so compelling. I just kept wanting to read it. It was really, really fantastic. It's been a while since I read it, and I think that I definitely would gain a lot from a reread. But just in general, I think more people need to read this book. I've never seen anybody else talk about it, so I definitely think it's an underrated piece of fiction, and I would highly recommend it. I believe that the author of this book, similarly to the main character, has Indian parents, but she grew up in different parts of the United States, but Minnesota is one of those places, so that was also fun for me as a Minnesotan to read a book that took place in Minnesota, where I live, but then also get to experience India, where I've never been. Another author on this list who also has ties to Minnesota is Swati Avasthi, and she wrote the book Split. This is the one book on my list where the family in it is not Indian. I was a little bit more hesitant to include this one, but I just wanted to recommend this book because it is so good and so underrated. Again, I don't think I've ever seen anybody read this book, like, never, and I loved it. So the author of this book, Swati Avasthi, I think was born in India. So like she is originally from India. She moved to the United States and eventually settled down in Minnesota. So she's kind of a local author for me. I'm not 100% sure if she still lives here, but I know that she did at least live here for many years. She also wrote this book, Chasing Shadows, which I own and have been putting off reading. I really need to read this book. So I can't recommend this book because I haven't read it, but it does look really interesting and it's half book, half graphic novel. So yeah, I've been excited to read this one for a long time, especially after reading Split, which is the one I'm gonna talk about right now. So Split is about this boy who at the beginning of the novel has gotten out of his home. He runs away from home and is reconnecting with his older brother and needs to live with him as like a place to stay. This is a book about domestic violence and abuse, and it has a lot of really intense and graphic depictions of this. So if that's something you're sensitive to, this might not be a good book for you to read. That is the main theme of this book, that these two boys and their mother have been abused by their father for many years. It is about getting out of that cycle of abuse and how hard that is, and the repercussions of growing up with an abusive parent, and just like how it so deeply has affected these two boys and just kind of their journey and like trying to move on from it. I cannot speak to the depiction of domestic violence. So I can't say 100% sure if there were issues with it or if there's something that I should be like mentioning that maybe it wasn't the greatest reflection of domestic abuse. But from what I can tell and from what I've read about this book in reviews, the author put a lot of research into it. I think she definitely did a good job of an honest portrayal of this topic. I think it was really eye-opening and really well done, at least from my limited perspective. I would love for someone with more knowledge or experience with this topic to review this book and let me know if there's anything that I'm missing about it, but that's what I can say for it for now. The book itself was just fantastic. Like, I really, really enjoyed the main character. He felt extremely real to me. He was just really, like, funny and charming and sarcastic. He was also really flawed. His flaws also felt super real. I feel like there was a lot of character growth in this book. It was just really well done, and I absolutely loved it. Wish more people would read it. I think the next two books I have are a little bit more well-known. So we have From Twinkle with Love by Sandhya Menon. When Dimple Met Rishi is probably the most famous book by Sandhya Menon. She writes mostly young adult contemporary stories, mostly romances, just like really, really sweet, charming, like happy contemporaries. And all of her books feature Indian protagonists. I think that this is so awesome. I really enjoy her books. I really enjoy that she's writing them. But like I was saying, When Dimple Met Rishi, I think is by far her most famous work. I did read that book and enjoy it, but I also read From Twinkle with Love, and this book I thought was even better. And I don't see people talking about this one quite as much. So I just want to give a special shout out to From Twinkle with Love. This follows our main character who is really into filmmaking, and she and her friends make like a Dracula film for a film festival competition at school. It is so fun to like experience this project that they're doing. I think that the behind the scenes stuff we get about the process of filmmaking was really, really good. I thought it was really, really interesting. I really enjoyed that. This book is told in diary format. It just immediately brought me back to a lot of diary format books that I used to read when I was younger. It just hit like such a good sweet spot for me. I was like, oh my god, like I haven't read a book like this in a really long time. And I used to love like the Princess Diaries books, Sloppy Firsts by Megan McCafferty. So this book was like simultaneously really refreshing, but also really nostalgic for me. Twinkle's inner monologue and her humor were so, so entertaining, like so good. The romance in this book was super cute. All around, it was just so fun. Really loved it. The fourth book on my list is another one that I think is pretty well known. You probably have heard of it before, but if you haven't read it, you need to. It's so good. I could not include it on this list. And it is Erotic Stories for Punjabi Widows by Bali Kaur Jaswal. This is a book that just has so many genres all wrapped up into one. There's so much to love about it and so much to enjoy about it. It follows this young woman who volunteers to teach this like writing class workshop for older women in her Indian community in the UK. She thinks that she's going to be teaching women points about writing short stories. It turns out that it's a bunch of really older women who don't know how to read or write English because they grew up in India. It follows this woman and like her respective story. It follows the different lives of all of these older women in this group, and it really just like talks about this community of Punjabi immigrants in the UK. There's like a mystery element to this book. There's humor, there's drama, there's a little bit of romance, and then there are also erotic stories, because what these women end up doing is they start writing their own erotic stories, and these stories are actually included in the book. They're actually really well written. It's a little bit weird, but it's also kind of fun to like have just like a little break from the story, and you get like a little mini little short story with like some erotic undertones in it. And what I really enjoyed about this is that the stories that these women write Yes, they're erotic stories, but each story is really revealing about certain insecurities or desires that these women have. A lot of these women haven't had a lot of agency, or they don't feel a lot of agency now, later in life. And the erotic stories that they write, like, really allow them to, like, be free about their innermost desires. It was just really well done. I absolutely loved this book. It was so good. Every time I think about it, it makes me happy. I saw a stranger the other day reading it, and I had to walk up to her and just be like, oh my god, I love that book so much. She was so nice and, like, so excited, and I was just, like, really excited for her to read it. Like, I want everyone to read this book. It's just so good. It's so good. The author of this book is, I think, from Singapore, and, like, grew up in a lot of different countries, but her family is pretty much all Punjabi, so I really enjoyed seeing this, like, community of people written about in this book, and it was just so good. And then the last book that I have to talk about is a graphic novel. It is Tina's Mouth, an Existential Comic Diary by Keshni Kashyap and Mari Araki. This follows a girl in high school, and this book starts out with her trying to do a project for her philosophy class. It all just kind of evolves into this huge philosophical conversation that she has with herself that's ongoing, and you watch this character go through so much and just grow and mature and evolve throughout the course of this school year. I loved it. I think she's a sophomore in high school, so she's pretty young, and I really, really felt for this main character. She just has, like, this depth to her that reminds me of the overlooked depth of a lot of actual teenagers that I know. So it just felt really genuine and really lovely. It's pretty long, and so, like, being with this character for so long, she really just made her way into my heart, and I just found this book to be very touching and lovely and enjoyable. Our main character has parents from India who moved to California to raise their children. I believe that the author of this book also has Indian parents who raised her in California. So I feel like there's a lot of personal influence in this book. And you can just kind of tell. It just feels so real. She is dealing with having crushes on boys, with friends drifting away from her, having to make new friends, her own personal, like, moral quandaries, her philosophical musings, and you also get to see her family, which I really enjoyed. She has a really large Indian family, and you get to see different members of her family crop up throughout the book. Her family provides a lot of humor in this book. Like, there's some really, really great characters. Overall, I just really enjoyed this, and again, this is another super underrated title on this list. I cannot think of another person I know who has read this book. So if you are into graphic novels, especially, like, standalone graphic novels, this is a fantastic, just standalone YA contemporary graphic novel. It's really good. So those are the 5 books that I had to recommend by Indian authors for Indian Independence Day. I really enjoy doing themed recommendation videos, especially ones centered around something that can help somebody read a little bit more diversely. So I really hope you enjoyed this. I definitely would love to hear your thoughts on any of these books if you've read them. If you want to give me Indian recommendations, I would love that. Let me know. Post your thoughts down below. I will talk to you guys tomorrow.